Hi, in the following video we will show you two methods of teaching our new capacitive sensors. First, using our digital potentiometer, and then using the teach monitor, which is a part of Turck's automation suite.
Parameterizing the new capacitive sensors starts in the simple way. We will start with using the screwdriver. Place the object in front of the sensor and turn the screwdriver clockwise until the LED changes its flashing behavior. When it flashes yellow, the object has been detected and the sensor has been taught. That's it. And now the sensor detects all objects which have the same or higher dielectrical value as the taught object. Scenario number two uses a dynamic teach to detect one type of an object. The object's values are displayed. The switching point has not yet been set. The dynamic teach allows the recording of the values during an ongoing process. So we start the teach. The objects presented in front of the sensor are measured and the values are recorded. The value has now been taught and a new switch point has been set. In this way, we can detect each object which is in front of the sensor and has the same or higher dielectrical value as the object which has been used for teaching. Now let's go into the next step and use a two-value teach. Therefore, we place an object stationary in front of the sensor. In this example, we will use full and empty bottles. Already you can see that the process value of the empty bottle has a different signal than the full bottles. This difference we will use for teaching. To do this, we place different objects in front of the sensor, in this case, a full bottle and an empty bottle. We begin with an empty bottle. Of course, you can use it also with an empty vessel or box or whatever. Next step is carrying out the teach for the full bottle. With the help of the two-value teach, we can detect whether bottles are full or whether they are empty. In this example, full bottles are detected. Of course, you can also detect empty bottles. Thank you for watching this video.